Hello guys, welcome back to the Class for Orals, DJ's Marine YouTube channel. For a long time back, the students have been asking what are the tips and tricks or suggestions how to prepare for the Class for Orals, because everyone knows that we are bound with the material and study material all around us. But in this video, we are going to discuss some hidden strategies and suggestions and some ways of attempting in the MMD oral in order to pass as soon as possible with the least attempts. In this video, we will be discussing some smart tips and tricks of attempting the orals, which will be helping us in boosting the candidate in the preparation. Remember, the knowledge is important, but in orals, confidence is more important. First of all, the MMD oral is an oral examination and it is not the MMD interview. What is the difference in both words? MMD oral examinations are where the examiner asks a student questioning related to the student's program of study. And if you are very good enough to perform well and prepare well for the first attempt, then surveyors do pass on a very good note on the very first attempt. So try to prepare very well and try to clear as much as functions in the very first attempt. And remember, it is not an MMD interview because the surveyor are mostly focusing only on the technical part of the exam. That's why it is called oral examination. For the class 4 orals, there are basically four functions, which are function 3, function 4b, function 5 and function 6, which are COSPOOL, MEOL, MROL and EUL respectively. If you are preparing very well, then it is suggested to give the first attempt of oral with all the four functions at a time, because there are high chances of getting passed with maximum functions in first attempt only, because it is taken as a good point and a good the surveyor usually gets happy when the candidate is coming with four functions at a time, because he considers that person as a daring and a strong candidate. But that is not a must case or mandatory. Some people who are not able to prepare for all functions, four functions together, that's why they split the functions in pairs. And in orals, sometimes surveyor usually ask and he gets fizzed off that why the candidates are splitting the subjects, because on ship, if any problem or any machinery troubleshooting comes, then it does not come keeping in mind the subject or the function. The problem is problem. That's why the surveyor usually looks for the candidates and he gets happy that the people are coming with all four functions. That means he is fully prepared to troubleshoot or sort out the problem on board ship. That is the main reason. They get happy if the person is coming with four functions at a time, and equally there are high chances of getting passed with maximum functions. When you are attempting for the oral, never specify any particular topic if asked. If surveyor is asking you that which all topics or which all subjects are you confident to date, or whichever subjects you have studied, or what functions you have prepared well, then please do not mention any specified subject or topic. That's why I have prepared this topic, or I have prepared this function very well, I have not prepared this function well, I am not confident. Please do not speak such kind of, please do not give such replies. You may fall into the trouble, because there are many situations and there are many examples when he can ask anything or any difficult question from that subject which you have mentioned, or he may not ask even a single question. So that is a bad luck for you. So how to deal with that question? Better, you have to say it confidently, sir, I have come here prepared, and after full preparation you can ask me anything from any topic. Even if you are not prepared, but replying this confidently will make that person okay, the candidate is confident and he can ask questions and continue with the oral. Suppose you are not able to answer correctly, better do not make any wild guess. Guesswork never works, Because if you are confused or you are not sure that what answer it is correct or not, it is always better to speak truth that, sir, sorry, I am not aware about the answer, although I had studied about it, but I am not able to remember that, and I do not make a wild guess here and make any trouble for me. So after you reply like this, the surveyor will be more happy and he may consider it as a good sign of a trustful officer-like quality, because not everyone knows everything about any subject. Some can prepare well, some can prepare, some may miss out something. So it is not mandatory that you may know 100% correct, but if you do not remember, it's better to speak truth and he can even pass you on that note. Please stick to your answer. There are many times the surveyor usually confuses the candidates because the candidate is never confident what he is replying before the surveyor. So he asks, are you sure that you answered this question correctly? Then the candidate usually gets confused and he thinks whether he is answering right or wrong. Then in that case, please stick to your answer, because if you change the answer upon his counter question, then you may end up in trouble. And suppose your answer is right, but after making you confused, you may change your answer and the surveyor might think that you are not confident enough and he may fail you on that note even. So confidence is the key in the oral examinations. The one thing which is commonly observed among the candidates, they are always asking notes, they are always asking friends, please give me this notes, give me that notes, and they are keep on asking. They are keeping, like they are piling up full material with them, PDFs, notes, handouts, but they are never making their own notes. So please make your own notes than studying from copied notes from others, because when you write your notes, you will be writing in your own handwriting and you will be memorizing those notes and stuff much more better than studying from any other person's notes. I'm not saying that referring the notes of another person is wrong. No, I want to state clearly that if you start making your own notes, then it will be very much helpful for you to revise on the last day. And please refer the original PDFs of MAPOL, SOLAS, FFA, LSA, codes and other conventions which are readily available online, and those should be updated and they are never incorrect, because the notes which are circulating among the people, they may be outdated or they may be circulating from the past 4 or 5 years. There may be many amendments which might be coming up in 2020, 2021 or maybe in future also. So those notes must be missing those important amendments and points. So it is always better to update your notes with the latest amendments and write your own notes. And for latest notes, you may find the MAPOL, SOLAS and FFA, LSA links in the description. And I have made one video also on that for the link, Google Drive links of major codes and conventions study material. You will find the link in the description in the PDF for the PDF files. Also, study latest amendments directly from the IMO website. That is the best place to study, because that will never be incorrect. And other classification societies as class NK societies and other classification societies. So alongside, start making notes, especially for the safety, that is a function 3. Possible function. Apart from that, you may enhance your study or preparation by joining the DGE Learning Test and Quiz on DG Shipping website. That is very well prepared by the DG Shipping, and you can also refer to the YouTube channel of the DGE Learning, in which they have listed out some 200 videos, short videos, animated type of videos, which are explaining how the machineries are overhauled and the basic information. That is a very good channel. You must refer those videos and try to study maximum with animations and YouTube videos having proper overhauling and working procedures, like man BMW videos, or you may refer to the electrical videos, how the motor works, and because those things usually people do not understand in the books, because that is more of animatory part. And also you can subscribe to our channel. If you are not subscribed yet, you can refer other people also and other platforms also for wholesome revision. And one more thing I would like to mention, for MEOL, MROL questions, people usually forget to study the manuals, because the manuals are the best sources of study, because almost everything, every kind of procedure, every kind of checks are given in the manuals. So you should and you must refer your ship specific manuals first, because that manual contains every information which is very much important, and most of the questions are asked directly from the manual questions. There are some informal or non-technical questions which are asked by the surveyor when you are just entering into the oral room, or you are giving the oral examination on online. So sometimes surveyor asks, tell us about yourself, then you have to prepare a short intro, and you should know what are the ship specific ship particulars of your past ships. Like you should know the deadweight tonnage, the GRT, the length, and some orals are asked ship specific. Please study diagrams and practice diagrams a lot, because majority of the questions asked in the orals are directly from the diagrams. Because if your diagram and your pipeline system and your functionality of the system, if you are clear with that, then most of the orals examinations are passed on that note. Because people do not study diagrams, they do not read from the diagrams, they just mug up the text and they mug up the content. But you must start preparing with the diagrams first, because if your diagram is good, you will be knowing what machinery is, how is the design working, and how the pipeline, and how is the process going on. Lastly, there are some data which needs to be memorized. It's a fixed data and with units. So you must memorize those data, because surveyors sometimes directly ask what are the data and values of that particular thing. So you should focus on memorizing the data correctly, and he may confuse you also, but you should remember those correct values and data with correct units. Sometimes people think that we have sailed in the bulk ships or we have sailed in the tanker ships, so the question will be asked only to the ship specific. No, that is a very wrong assumption, because even if you sail in the bulk, you may be asked the IC system of the tanker ship, or in tanker ship, if you have sailed, you may be asked about the bulk carrier ship. So you have to study everything, study wholesome, because in future you may be placed on any kind of ship. So you cannot say that, no, I'm not sailed on this kind of ship, I will not go there. Because here choice work does not work. You have to be all-rounder and study wholesome and everything. Basically, from each function, on an average, 5 to 6 questions are usually asked, because there are plenty of candidates waiting outside, and the surveyor usually does not have much time. So there's approximately 5 to 6 questions asked from each function. So if you answer more than 3 or 4 correctly, then there are fair chances to pass that oral. At least 80% or out of 3 to 4 questions out of 5 questions, you should actually answer correctly. All questions should be correct. But if you are passing maximum 70 to 80% of the answers correctly, confidently, then there are fair chances of passing that oral. And if surveyor points out that you are answering wrong, you might be right. But if the surveyor is constantly telling you that your answer is wrong, never argue with the surveyor. It may end up in problem. And just stay calm and accept that, okay sir, I might be wrong, you are right. Remember, it is oral examination and it is not a debate where you can fight. So mark this point also. The most important thing for oral examination is that you cannot study alone, because you need a group discussion nowadays. So pick up a friend or make a group of friends who are active in the group discussions, who who are very much good in studying. So pick up a topic every day and start discussion, because if you do not speak out or if you do not discuss, you will not know what all preparations you are going through, or are you actually doing good preparation, or are you memorizing wrong data, or are you preparing well or not. So that will be evaluated after you are discussing in group. So please join active WhatsApp groups or Telegram groups. You can find the questions and answers being asked and discussed in the orals. So please participate in the group discussion in the WhatsApp and Telegram groups. And if you want to join the WhatsApp links and Telegram groups, I have put the links in the description of the video. You can straight away click those links and join the channel and the groups for Telegram and WhatsApp groups. Please answer only those points which you are 100% sure of. Like, do not answer 50% or 60% of any question. Better stay silent and do not answer. If you are 100% sure of that answer, then it will be a very good point. But if you start any point and if you end up like you do not know 100% of that, then it will be considered as a bad impression before the surveyor. So better play safe and answer precisely whatever you know 100% correct. If any point you are not sure of or you are not 100% correct, then better do not speak out those points. And also explain surveyor as if he is your student. Because if the surveyor is asking you a question, you should explain like a faculty. You should explain him step by step, slowly, precisely, and short and crisp. Because if you explain too lengthy or too much lengthy explanation, then he may feel bored and he may think that you are exaggerating the answer. And sometimes if you study one word type, that also works. So work upon that in the preparation. Sometimes the surveyor asks about overhauling procedure of any machinery, suppose motor, or he is asking about motor overhaul or generator overhauls, any kind of overhaul he may ask. Please do not directly jump or rush to answer from the overhauling procedure only. This is a trap. Even people appearing for the class 2 orals and class 4 orals, they fall in this trap because they forget to start with proper safety procedures and paperwork before commencement of the overhauling. So always take work permit and proper risk assessment and tell him that, sir, before starting the overhaul, I will consider the work permit and risk assessment and proper logout tagout. And if all safety precautions are taken, then proceed for the machinery overhaul. Because if you start your answer like this, the surveyor will be happy that yes, the candidate has considered safety standards also. So always tell that, sir, I will take work permit first, I will carry out the risk assessment and proper logout and tagout. Please do not choose any kind of MMD which is so far from your town. Always choose the nearest MMD. Why? First of all, it reduces the pressure on the individual MMD. And sometimes surveyor also asks candidates that, why did you choose this MMD and why did you not choose the MMD nearer your town? So the surveyor thinks that the candidate has come because he wants to pass early, because he thinks the passing rate of here is higher than the passing rate of other MMDs. No, every MMD is of same level to pass a candidate. Always remember, if you perform and if you answer correctly, there's no question of MMD city or whatever. It has nothing to do with that. They are always there to pass you, and if you are studying properly, you are passed. Simple. All MMDs are of same level, and please do not fall into the higher passing rate, that Mumbai MMD has higher passing rate or Delhi MMD has less passing rate, the Kochi MMD has higher passing rate. No, all MMDs are same. Please stop discriminating the MMDs. Just join the and take oral examination nearer to your MMD. It will add up as a good point before the surveyor that yes, you have reduced the burden on another MMDs. Otherwise, it will be a pressure on them to pass the candidates. One thing is that before actual date of oral examination, let it be physical or online nowadays because of the COVID situations, the online oral have been started by DG Shipping, by MMD. So start rehearsing online on Microsoft Teams, which is actually taken by MMD, or any other webinar platform like Zoom or any other Cisco, with your friends in 1 month in advance of the actual oral date. Why? Because you do not want to end up in trouble on the actual day of MMD oral. Check your internet connection, whether it is recharged or not. Check your laptop condition. Set up your room properly. Like you really want to attempt the oral that day. Set up the room like that. Prepare the oral. Prepare in the full formal dress and maintain the decorum. And keep your desktop clear with no study material. Practice and create the actual oral examination kind of scenario with your friends and discuss them daily. So it will make you more confident, and it will remove your hesitation on the day of actual oral, and it will make you more confident enough. Lastly, if you have not performed well, or if you get to find reattempts, or if you fail in the oral examination, do not feel bad. Please rise again. Do not get disheartened. Take it as in a positive manner. Think where you went wrong. Take the challenge and study again with more enthusiasm and dedication. And do not worry about the number of attempts, because when you will be clearing the class or CSC, you will be only thinking that yes, I have cleared my exam. You will forget all those attempts, that how much attempts you took to clear that exam. So do not feel bad. But yes, stay dedicated and with extra enthusiasm than before. I hope this video would have made you more confident, and would have it would have told you how to prepare and how to appear in the oral examination rather just mugging up in for the exam. And please feel free to share anything. If you have any oral kind of oral experience of MMD with you, you may write in the comment section below. And welcome any kind of suggestions and feedbacks on this video. And this channel is dedicated to the all the seafarers appearing for class 4 examinations. And if you have not subscribed yet, and you have not shared this channel to your fellow colleagues, please do share, because this channel is purely dedicated for the people to clear the examination in the least attempts. And in future, we will be coming up with the more videos and more alerts. Please subscribe here. And till then, all the best and study well, stay alert, stay confident, and bon voyage. Thank you so much.